conscious are you of the divine within you is the matter. How big, how difficult is outside situation is not the matter. How God of glory, God who turns everything into good is in you. The consciousness of the presence of God who turns everything into good is the matter. Well, today we move on to another prophet called the prophet Samson. So he too received life from God, and he too had the same mission to bring life and salvation to the world. Each one of us, as we read in Jeremiah 29:11, are sent with a mission to this world. No one is created for a joke. No one is created to die in problem and suffering. If you think that you are dying in your suffering, in your misery, sorry, you have not understood the Lord nor the call of God. Yes. So the Lord is calling each one of us to walk with the Savior, that we may walk within us. That we may walk within us, that we can lead outside the world. Lead us outside the world. So when we read in the book of Samson, his parents called Manoah and his wife, both were longing for the children. And for many years, life, conception is not taking place in their family. No child is found. But they were praying couple. Every day they used to fast. Every day they used to pray. They never got discouraged. Let not the internal conflict take away our external piety. So external piety may keep us always, it may take us always to the river. Though going to the river, your thirst is not quenched. External piety is not going to solve our problem, but external piety will keep us close to the river, close to go to church, close to prayer. Yes. So they were pious people. They were praying people. Maybe they are novena people. So they continued to pray so many novenas, so many prayers. But nothing has happened to them. And one day, as they were praying, especially Manoah's wife, God came and told her, external piety, if it has to bear fruit, it has to be united with internal cleansing. Without internal cleansing, your external piety will never bear fruit for you. So your internal cleansing is a must. To have internal cleansing, you have to follow 5 stages of self-knowledge of who are you, self-awareness, what is happening to you, self-purification, and self-empowerment, and self-soul winning. We will have some another day about this great theme. Now, we will reflect that Lord reveals to the parents of Samson, if your external piety, going here and there, running to this church, doing this prayer, that prayer, crying, weeping, shouting, well, if that has to bear fruit, it has to go along with internal cleansing. So, in the book of Judges, chapter 13, verse 4, we read, the Lord came and spoke to Manoah's wife. Well, look, you are going on running here and there, crying. If things have to take place in your life, listen what you need to do. Yes.
Now, be careful not to drink wine or strong drink.
So, please take care. What type of things you are eating? What type of things you are drinking? What are the things that enter into you? What are the things that are found in your mind? What are the issues that are going through in your life? Somebody got angry and you become mad. Somebody speaks something negative about you and you become angry and upset. The Lord told very clearly, see, you have to take care. One side you are drinking wine, you are doing all that, and you are shouting at your family, you are shouting at your companions, you are shouting at your husband, wife, or your children, and making all tamasha at home, and then you want God to bring forth life. It doesn't go through. You have to be aware of your dieting. What do you eat? What kind of food you eat? You know, in the Bible, food is always the thought. Food never means only the mere food, rice and dal or chapati. God's word is food, which gives the new thought of God. Man cannot live by bread alone, but from the food that comes from God, the thought of God, the planning of God, the thinking of God, the way God leads man has to be part of our life. So the Lord tells, if you have to bear fruit, if child has to be born in your family, if life has to move through you, if anointing has to come out of you, without considering, without seeing, without working on your internal cleansing, don't expect your external piety to bear fruit. So you have to know yourself, who are you. That's why in the book of Proverbs, chapter 4, verse 13, we read, more than anything else, be in touch with your heart. From there, the source of life flowing to you. That's why he says, 2 Corinthians, that's why we read in Genesis chapter 39, verse 9, the boy who has to move with the life of God, Joseph, he had a lot of problems, lot of situation. People were tempting him. People were trying to put him into jail. People were trying to give him all kinds of problems. The Lord says, external struggle will not touch you if you could keep up your internal cleansing. If you are internally cleansed, you will internally hold on to the presence. And the internal presence of the divine will help you to overcome the external aggression. The internal presence of the divine alone will help you to overcome the external aggression and external conflict that come on in and around you. So take care of your internal thoughts. What type of thoughts you are putting into your mind when you see somebody? When you come to the church, you say hallelujah. When you come to your brother, you got so angry. All filthy words, all filthy thoughts come. You feel like, that's why when a woman called Joseph for sin, she said, hello, you are the wife of somebody else. How can I do this great sin? The people who don't understand the working of God, they will call it a weakness. There is no weakness in sin. Weakness is to your body. Sin is a sin. Sin is an aggression against God who wants to work with us. So you cannot say fallen into sin and then call yourself it's a weakness. That is the language of the evil spirit, to cover up, not allowing us to go deeper into the truth. Yes. So the young man says, how can I do this great sin and displease the God who trusts me? So it is against your own self for growth, and it is against the working of God who wants to build you up. So the sin becomes a power to stop you growing, and sin becomes a power to stop your God to help you to grow in. So that's what we find. So first thing the Lord spoke to Manoah and his wife, saying, hello, if external piety has to bear fruit in your life, be in touch with your internal thoughts. What type of food you eat, what type of thoughts that you put into your mind, what type of thoughts that come out of your mind, your mouth, you got to be in touch with that. And that thoughts and mind has to be in line with God, that God's life can come out of you.